What up? It's the Trooper. Yo, it's Tuesday, downtown at the Golden Nugget, pool action. Got a lunch meeting with a friend about a thing, partially about some pizza, but partially about another thing. So, yeah, after that, probably poker. Trooper, where are you gonna play poker? I don't know, Golden Nugget? Maybe more. Yo, I know you can't feel this weather because you're not in Vegas today, but it is a beautiful day here. I mean, it is just a beautiful day out there. Holy crap, holy. This damn Fremont Street action. Look out yonder in the distance. Got that Pizza Rock action going. Our boards. So I considered going to Red Rock to play. I also considered going home and playing on WSOP.com, streaming it on Twitch. Camera, so slow. But I'm downtown. I'm here at the Golden Nugget. I think I'm just gonna play here. Shit's strong. All right, I had to grab an iced coffee. I'm on the list. There are only two no limit games going. Hopefully I don't have to wait very long. I can get really unmotivated really quickly. So Tuesdays are usually the slowest day for poker on the strip, but it looks like there's some action going on the strip. As you can see right here, somebody tweeted me this video. It's just something they saw on Twitter, and it's pretty hilarious, and I can't believe that I missed it because I'm downtown. I'm not wandering around in front of the forum shops. That's one of the most ridiculous things I've seen in Vegas, even though I didn't actually see it. Speaking of things being slow, it was actually kind of slow in the Golden Nugget as well. Tonight. Actually, I say tonight, and now I realize it's not even all the way dark yet. I thought it was later than this. I actually didn't want to play that late tonight anyway. I need to get up early tomorrow, but I did win 175. I made a pretty strong hold on the river. It is so loud out here. I can't even believe how loud it is. It's coming from all directions. I was saying that I made a pretty strong fold. I had pocket fours. Somebody made it 12. We saw the flop, or maybe it was 10. We saw the flop, now it's windy. Vlogging problems. Which way is it coming from? We saw the flop four ways. I was second to act post-flop with pocket fours. The flop was queen 10-4, rainbow action. The pre-flop raiser was the last to act post-flop. So the first guy checks. I considered making a small bet, but I didn't do it. I checked. Guy on my left checked. Pre-flop raiser checks. Turn card is a five. A five of clubs to put a club draw on board. First to act bets $12. This is a mistake. I had played a hand against this guy already, and I really should have played this more aggressively, but I didn't. I called 12. Guy on my left called 12. Pre-flop raiser folded. The river card is an eight. No club. Flush did not come in. But we have a queen, 10, 4, 5, 8. So the first to act guy bet 25. I slightly considered just calling because 6, 7 now makes a straight, and also jack 9 makes a straight. Jack 9 would have been open-ended on the flop. 6, 7 would have been open-ended on the turn, which is when the guy bet, but you gotta remember, the pre-flop raiser was last pre-flop. So the guy, if he's betting a draw, which he was, he may have waited till the turn anyway with jack 9. I raised it to 75. Guy on my left folded, went back to the guy. He paused briefly, and then went all in for a total of 225. So I folded and showed him my hand. Well, in the hand that we played earlier, I had pocket kings and checked back the flop, the queen high flop. And on the turn, he checked and I bet 15 and he went all in for 70. And of course I snap called. He had second pair, but the river gave him two pairs. So he won the pot. Well, he was apologetic, which is not a good thing to be at the poker table, but he was. So when I showed him the fours and folded the set, I said, if you actually feel bad about the first hand, then show me this one. He showed me jack nine. I knew that there was just no way the guy was full of shit because he knows I'm not full of shit with my 75. So if he knows I have a real hand and he still moves in for 225, he's got it. I know he's got it. Of course he had it. I contend that bet folding there is the right move because he would have called 50 more if he rivered two pair, or if he had turned two pair, or if he had flopped two pair, if he had queen 10, if he had 4-5, or if he had queen 8, or even 10-8, he would have called 50 more. So 50 more is a bet I think he would have called with a worst hand, but I don't think he's raising with a hand that I beat. And I was right. Nonetheless, I win exactly 175, and now I'm out here wandering about, and it's still daylight. Earlier, I had one slice of pepperoni at Pizza Rock. That was hours ago, and now I'm pretty hungry again. Dare I? Oh yeah, I dare. I definitely dare. So earlier when I was here with Mike, I wanted Detroit slice, and they didn't have Detroit at the time, but now they got Detroit. Not only do they have Detroit, but they have Detroit with pepperoni, which I never had here before. Oh my gosh, just the pepperoni is like, holy shit. They have the best pepperoni in the world. Look at that. I know what you're thinking. Trooper, how are you gonna eat pizza twice in one day? The answer to your question is contained within your question. The very first word, trooper. Holy shit, I gotta tell you. Good pie the other day, they had good pizza. The normal New York slice or whatever was really good. But I had the Detroit there. That shit was nothing compared to this. I mean, absolutely nothing. This is the best shit ever. Oh yeah. Goodbye, don't know how to do it. I know what you're thinking. Trooper, do you feel guilty? Pizza two times in one day? First of all, I know you're not thinking that because you know the answer to that. Hell no, I don't feel guilty. That shit was so good. I don't get Pizza Rock every day. Thinking, no, this time I really do know what you're thinking. You think a trooper, why would you go home so early? You should keep playing for a few hours more. And you're probably right. But I do need to get up early tomorrow. Tomorrow I'm streaming at noon on Instant Poker on Twitch. Doesn't this remind you of the Desert Manor days? When I first moved here and I used to walk from Desert Manor to Fremont Street all the time. It reminds me of it. Those were the days, huh? Ha! It was good and bad. For someone like me, living at Desert Manor can be a difficult, sometimes painful experience. But I adapted. You know, they make waterproof mattress covers, right? And then you could nail a sheet to the wall, right? You could do that. You could just not touch anything inside the unit. Ha, I said unit. Am I going to five? No, I need to go to six. What the hell am I doing? You know, things have changed since 5 years ago. We're getting very close to 5 years. We're getting very close to the 5-year anniversary of me arriving in Vegas. With two dime pieces in my pocket. That would be June 2nd. That will be the 5-year anniversary. of arriving here in Vegas. June 9th will be the 2-year anniversary of Go Gamble. That's one of the things that's changed. 2 years ago, Go Gamble came into existence. Funnily enough, is that a word? Funny enough, that's what I was talking to Mike about today. I think Mike and I are going to collaborate on some Go Gamble stuff. We shall see. Yo, remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends about the videos and leave a comment down below. I'm gonna see you next time.